My first track takes me back to when I was 13 years old, growing up in Southsea. In one of the arcades, there used to be a jukebox. The older lads used to have the money to put in it. We never did. We used to sit and listen, or ponce a tune if we could. So here we are. It was a choice, my first one, between Freddie and the Dreamers or Shorty Long. And guess what? For the next couple of years, I was intrigued now by good soul and Motown that was coming through. We were over bombarded by the Kinks and the Beatles. Not that that wasn't a bad thing at that age, but there was a lot more stuff out there. I can remember one Saturday afternoon, and this is real, honestly, it never left me. But I was sat in the Manhattan Coffee Bar in Palmy Road. And my friend Stephen came in and said, "Here, guess what? Otis Redding's died." And it never left me. I always thought, what a sad time. Such a talent, gone so early. So there you go. That's my next track, Otis Redding.
Maybe weary. Them young girls, they do get wearied wearing that same old miniskirt dress. Yeah. But when she gets weary, you try your little tenderness. Yeah. Oh man, now I know she's waiting, just anticipating for things that she'll never possess. No. But while she's there waiting, try just a little bit of tenderness. That's all you got to do. Now it might be a little bit sentimental, no, no, no. But she has her griefs and care, yeah, 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 yeah. But the soft words, they are spoke so gentle, yeah, yeah, yeah. And it makes it easier to bear. Oh, really, no, no. Young girls, they don't forget it. But it's all so easy. All you got to do is try, try. Tenderness, yeah, man. All you got to do is know how to love her. You got to hold her, squeeze her, never leave her.
So here we go then now. Teenager. Sharp suits, Ben Sherman shirts and royals. Loved it. Couldn't get enough of it. Everywhere you went, the next track used to be played. Opened the door for me into one of the other best bands that ever came through it all.
Look
Mecca days, Mondays and Thursdays, 1 and 6. Couldn't get in without a tie though, but it was well worth it. See all your mates, see all the girls. Pompey was growing up. It was all brand new. Everything was brand new. I loved it.
We was working at the Stacey Club in Cotner, putting a new central heating system in. And the manager gave us a free jukebox whilst we was there. Drove everybody mad with this next track. Played it to death. J-Mo Thomas, I Spiked by the FBI. I was now working part-time at the Mecca, fixing microphones and doing lights. Although I was an apprentice heating engineer, this gave me an extra few bob. But I blew it all anyway on records and probably lager. Johnny Taylor, Who's Making Love? Give me that.
There is something you never even thought of. Now tell me who's playing. does it too. I'm not trying to run your life. Choice is up to you. Are you?
So we move on. We move on quite a bit, actually. I've grown out of it by now. And I was settled, I was married, and I was having to work hard. That's what you did. No more clubbing. If they offered you a weekend on double time. But then I met Kim Shepherd. And he started to play stuff to it I had never heard. And we used to sit around his house and play these hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of records that he used to get. And out of all of them, this one track stood out so much. There were so many good tracks, but this one track I absolutely love. Johnny Bragg, They're Talking About Me. Moving on again to another significant part of my life. I had a daughter and she used to like dancing with her dad. She said we used to dance like nutters. Always makes me laugh. Never left me either. Always remembered this track of David Peaston, Can I? Again, what a fantastic record.
Can I have a talk with you? can I make a dream come true? Oh, can I be in love with you? Here's why I need to know. 'Cause can I set your soul on fire? Ooh, baby. Can I be your one and only desire? Just haven't realized that I'm lonely too, and all I want to do is bring happiness to me.
Last track is just that person, that one man, that one singer that made so much difference all through my life. If ever I was somber or melancholy, I could turn to this guy and listen to his stuff, and it used to make me think. I was lucky as well. I managed to see him in 1976 at the Albert Hall in a matinee, would you believe, first house. And he stood no more than 6 foot away from me. I was sat right in the centre and he stood there, and it was wonderful. And this track, I never thought I'd share with anybody else. I was going to wait till the curtains closed and this was going to be the grand finale. But it kind of sums everything up to me. I ain't a religious person particularly, but it just sums it all up. And this is just like perfect. This is Marvin Gaye and Dream of a Lifetime.
I've had